Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic classification of the organic compounds based on their structure. Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have studied about the representation of the organic compounds. And let me give you an information that there are basically 27 million of the organic compounds that have been known to us. So such a huge number of the organic compounds that we know, so that's the reason it is very necessary for us to classify them based on their structure. So what are the classifications of the organic compounds based on their structure? This is what we are going to study about. So let us start with that. So the classification of the organic compounds, it starts with the organic compound, as we know that it are basically divided into two parts, that is an open chain organic compound and a closed chain organic compound. So let me give you a glimpse of it by drawing the tree diagram over here. That is, the organic compound is basically is of two type, that is an open chain organic compound, or you could call it as open chain compound, and that is closed chain compound. So the open chain compound are also basically known as the aliphatic organic compounds, while that of the closed chain organic compounds are basically known as the that is cyclic chain compounds. So aliphatic organic compounds, or we could also call it as that is acyclic carbon atoms or organic compounds. The reason behind that is because all the carbon atoms that are being arranged in that is acyclic, or we could call it as open chain, they are not forming a cycle, and hence the name is acyclic organic compound. Okay, but the closed chain carbon atoms, they are basically known as that is the cyclic chain organic compounds. For example, that is butane, hexane. So these are the basically open chain organic compounds. While talking about the next one, that is benzene. So benzene is the one which is basically a closed chain compound, or we could also say it as a cyclic chain compound. So that is the reason these organic compounds are mainly divided into two parts. But talking about the first one, that is open chain compounds, are also been divided into two parts, and those are straight chain and branched chain organic compounds. So talking about the first one, that is straight chain, as the name itself suggests, that is the carbon atoms that are being attached to each other, they will form a straight chain, and that is the reason they are called to be that is straight chain organic compounds. And talking about the branched chain organic compounds, so branched chain organic compounds if I would say like tertiary butyl bromide, so even that is an organic compound, but they form a branched one. So that is the reason they are called as branched chain. So let me give an example so that it will be very much clear to us to understand that how are they classified into. So talking about the first one, that is if I am taking an example like so for example, this is butane, and as we could see that this chain doesn't consist of any branched one, and this is the longest chain that we know. So that is the reason it is called to be an open chain. So the name of this one is basically butane. And talking about the another one, and suppose for another example that we have to like this one, that is CH3CH2. So this is an example that I have wrote over here, but talking about this one, this is called to be that is acyclic, or we could call it as aliphatic, or we could call it as open chain organic compound. The reason behind that is it is not forming a cyclic form. So you can't see a cycle form is because of the carbon atoms that are being attached to each other. So that is the reason that it is said to be an open chain organic compound. And talking about the name of this one, then the name of this one according to the IUPAC, it would be called as that is 2,2 dimethyl butane. So this is what we have named it. But talking about the first one, that is the first one, the as it doesn't consist of any kind of branching, so therefore this is an example of a straight chain organic compound. While talking about this one is the one which is an open chain, as well as it is forming a branch one. So as you could see that in the long chain, as you could see, this is the longest chain, and in this longest chain we could see a branched one. So that is the reason that this has been called to be that is a branched chain organic compound. So these were the two classifications that we have did for that is aliphatic organic compounds. So now the remaining part is that yes, we have to disclose about what are the classifications under, that is closed chain organic compound. So let us talk about that also. So I'm doing it separately so as to understand that what are the different types of the closed chain carbon or closed chain organic compounds. So therefore, so the closed chain organic compounds are basically divided into basically two parts, and those are basically, they can be homocyclic or they could be heterocyclic. So let me just draw the tree diagram over here and we'll discuss about it later. So talking about the closed chain organic compounds, closed chain organic compounds are divided into two parts, that is, as I've said earlier also, that is homocyclic organic compounds and heterocyclic organic compounds. So talking about the that is the first one, that is homocyclic organic compounds. As the name suggests, that is it will consist of basically carbon and hydrogen only, and that will form a closed chain. For example, if a carbon chain has been forming a closed chain, and in that case, because of no other atom rather than that of the carbon is being attached in the ring form, so therefore that would be called as a homocyclic compound. But talking about the heterocyclic compound, so in that cyclic form or in that cyclic chain, one of the atom should be rather than that of the carbon and hydrogen, and that could be like oxygen, sulfur, phosphorus, etc. So therefore that would be called as the heterocyclic compound. So talking about the homocyclic compound, let me give an example. Just like if I talk about that is N-butane. So N-butane is the one that is forming a straight chain. So therefore it won't be considered to be that is a homocyclic. So but if I talk about cyclobutane, so cyclobutane is the one that is an example of, because it is forming a cycle, as in the name also it is suggested that in the cyclic form the carbon are been attached to each other, as we could see, so as to complete the whole cycle, and that's the reason that it is called to be homocyclic. While talking about the next is heterocyclic, so just like pyrrole, so pyrrole is a kind of closed chain, or we could call it as a cyclic chain compound, in which it doesn't consist of only carbon atom in the chain, but to form a chain, but it also consists of the nitrogen. So that's the reason that it has been called as heterocyclic. So that's the reason that hetero is for the one which is different than that of the carbon. And talking about the homocyclic, so as the name suggests, homo means it should, the whole cycle should consist of at least carbon atom that are attached to each other, and this is the two division of it. So now let us understand that if there are more classification under homocyclic compounds or not. And yes, there are classification under homocyclic compounds also. So let me explain that. So homocyclic compounds are basically divided into two types or into two classifications. And the first one is that is alicyclic compounds, and the next one is aromatic compounds. So the alicyclic compounds and the aromatic compounds, so these are the two things that are under, that is homocyclic compounds. And talking about the first one, that is in alicyclic compounds, so these are the homocyclic compounds which consist of carbon atoms that are being arranged in a cyclic form, and in this case they are not said to be an aromatic. Yes, there are different criteria of a substance to under to give a classification whether that is an aromatic or not, but talking about the alicyclic one, so alicyclic one is not an aromatic compound. So it is a cyclic form, but it is not aromatic. For example, if I am talking about butane, or if I am talking about like cyclopropane, so cyclobutane and cyclopropane, these are the two compounds that are not aromatic, but yes, they are forming a chain of the carbon atoms. So let me give you an example so that we could easily understand that what is the difference between alicyclic and that is aromatic compound. So this was the example that we have studied earlier, but now let us understand that how can we write an example of an alicyclic compound. For example, so this is the compound that we have, or else we could have a compound like this one, or else we could have a compound like this one. So these are the three things that I have drawn over here, and we have to mention that they are under the classification of alicyclic or not. So talking about the first one, that is this is called to be that is cyclopropane. And as you know that this chain is made up of the carbon only, because carbon atoms are being involved so as to form this chain. So therefore this is the carbon atom that it has, the another carbon atom and this carbon atom. So they are forming bond with each other, as you could see over here, so as to form a cyclic compound. And since it consists of only carbon atoms, so therefore it is a homocyclic compound. And if we know that there are further classification of the homocyclic compounds, and in which we could see that it is not forming an aromatic compound, but moreover it is forming a carbon chain that is basically less than 6 atoms are been attached over here in this case, and there is no kind of the criteria like unsaturated carbon atoms or alternate conjugate carbon single bond and double bond, and they are not planar or and all. So that makes this to be non-aromatic. So therefore this is a non-aromatic carbon atom or organic compound, and that is the reason that it is called to be aliphatic. So talking about this one, that is, this is cyclobutane. Even this cyclobutane has been the chain has been formed, or the close chain has been formed, because of the carbon atoms that have been attached to this one, and that's the reason that it is the homocyclic compound, and moreover we could say that it is homocyclic aliphatic organic compound. And even this is cyclobute, that is, if we name it in the terms of five bases, so therefore this would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So therefore the name of this one would be cyclo 1,3-butadiene. So therefore this is the name of this structure, and all, if you could see, that is, all are being connected through the carbon atoms only, and hence they are said to be the homocyclic organic compounds, and moreover we could say homocyclic, that is alicyclic organic compounds. And so this were the example of this one. And let me talk about what is the difference between the aromatic compound. So aromatic compounds are those compounds which consist of at least one benzene ring in it, or it should look like a benzene ring. So, and since we are talking about that is a homocyclic, so therefore the whole chain, it should consist of carbon only. So that's the reason that if we draw the structure of the first one, that is the first aromatic compound that we know, that is benzene. So benzene comes under the classification of that is homocyclic and aromatic, that is organic compound. And as we could see that all the carbon atoms have been arranged so as to form a cycle one. So therefore benzene is known to be a homocyclic aromatic compound. And talking about the another one, that is, this is aniline. So aniline is also comes under the homocyclic aromatic compound, and the reason behind that is, as you could see that the carbon atoms are being responsible so as to form the chain, and in this case the nitrogen is out of the chain, and that's the reason it is said to be that is a homocyclic aromatic compound. So this were the two things that I have to discuss over here, that is for this one. That is for the homocyclic one, and that were the alicyclic compounds and the aromatic compounds. So now let us talk about deeply about what are the heterocyclic compounds and what are the classification that comes under those. So talking about the first one in this case is, now let us talk about what are the classification of the heterocyclic compounds. So therefore, so talking about the heterocyclic compounds, and as we know that heterocyclic compounds are forming are those cyclic compounds which consist of a basically a hetero atom. And what are the hetero atoms? That are basically oxygen, sulfur, phosphorus, and these are the hetero atoms because they are not related to that of the carbon atom. And because hydrocarbons are those who forms, that is due to combination of the carbon atoms and the hydrogen atom, and these are basically known as the hetero atoms, that is this oxygen, sulfur, phosphorus and etc. So now this heterocyclic compounds will form a cyclic form, and in which basically a hetero atom would be involved, and that's the reason that they are called to be heterocyclic compounds. So they are basically classified into two types. The first one is hetero alicyclic compounds, and the next one is hetero aromatic compounds. So talking about the hetero alicyclic compounds, so these are very similar to that of the alicyclic compounds that we have did earlier only. But talking about, this is not alicyclic, this is hetero alicyclic, means in this case the cycle chain or the chain which consists of carbon atom, it will not only consist of carbon atom, but it will consist of an hetero atom, and this would not be that of like aromatic, this would be alicyclic itself. So taking an example of this one, so this arpene also been further can be given an example. In this case, suppose if I give an example like so this is basically known as a tetrahydrofuran, or basically known as THF. And in this case, basically, as you could see that this is an example where we could see that the carbon atoms are been, not only carbon atoms are been involved in forming a cycle chain, but a hetero atom like oxygen is also been involved so as to form a cyclic compound. So that's the reason it is called to be hetero alicyclic compounds. And this compound, that is THF, tetrahydrofuran, is not an aromatic compound, because it doesn't consist of a unsaturated carbon-carbon double bond and or conjugated system of double bond, and that's the reason it is called to be alicyclic compound. But talking about the next one, that is hetero aromatic compounds. So hetero aromatic compounds are also been classified into two types, and what are those? Let me give the classification here itself. So now let us talk about the hetero aromatic compounds. So now hetero aromatic compounds are basically divided into again two types, and in this case one would be and since it is known to be an cyclic compound which is aromatic, but it consists of an hetero atom that has been connected in the whole cycle form of the carbon chain. And let me give an example that these are been divided into two parts, that is hetero benzenoid compounds and hetero non-benzenoid compounds. So talking about the example of this one, that is of benzenoid compounds, or we could call it as hetero benzenoid compounds. So talking about the example so that we could understand it. So the name of this structure is basically it's known as pyridine, and this is an aromatic compound. But talking about this one, that is so this one is it's looking like an benzene, and hence it is also an aromatic compound, and hence that's the reason that pyridine is a kind of we could say it as a hetero benzenoid compound. And the name hetero suggests that the whole carbon chain that it has, as we could see over here, that is the carbon chain, it has been made up of, the cycle chain is made up of carbon chain, but it should consist of at least one hetero atom, and in this case the hetero atom is nothing but the nitrogen, and hence it is called to be hetero benzenoid compound, because this structure looks like benzene, and hence it is an aromatic compound also. So that is the reason pyridine is kind of an hetero benzenoid compound. While talking about the other one, that is hetero non-benzenoid compounds. So these are basically the aromatic compounds, but they don't look like that of the benzene, or they don't have a resemblance of that kind of benzene, or they don't have any kind of benzene that has been attached to that one. So that's the reason I could give an example like this one, that is. So now basically this is a structure that we have drawn, and this is nothing to be that similar to that of the benzene, because benzene consists of 6 carbon atoms, or a cycle chain of 6. So but this doesn't consist of 6 carbon atoms, so therefore if we count, so therefore this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that is atoms are being known to form a cycle. So therefore this is not a benzene, but it is basically called to be non-benzenoid compound, and the name of this is azocene. And this is an example of an hetero non-benzenoid compound. So this is the thing that I wanted to explain you. So this were the classification. So this were the few examples that I have discussed in this case, so as to classify that how many kinds of the aromatic compound that have been present. So that's all based on the structure. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.